My name is Paul Egan, and I am the Chief Technology Officer at 3Share, a Platinum Adobe implementation partner for Experience Cloud-related products. So over the years, 3Share has advised on and deployed hundreds of digital asset management systems for clients built on top of AM assets. Many of these clients look to us for our expertise in content automation, and many of these automation and production projects start off as AEM assets implementations, but quickly grow to include a more robust tool like Adobe Workfront to manage all aspects of the creative process. Perhaps the most common starting point for workflow and project execution within Workfront is some sort of creative brief, which I'm going to talk a little bit about today. Now, a creative brief typically takes the form of a PDF, something like we are seeing now. And the idea of it is it captures information about a project prior to start that allows the project to be approved and then ultimately delivered. And so for most teams, even smaller ones, this PDF starts to become cumbersome when you pass it around to colleagues to gain the approvals you need to start the work. And then once you're done with the project, how do you manage all the information that you learned during the project? Or, you know, spend, budgeting, all that stuff. How do you tie that back to the original brief? As that process gets more cumbersome, obviously you want to replace it with a tool like Workfront. And what we typically advise is before you try and do away with everything, you really need to ask yourself two questions. What types of requests do you receive as an organization? And how would you like to receive these types of requests? And within Workfront, it's very easy to map those two questions to actual pieces of functionality within the tool. So custom forms within Workfront is really the what. So what information am I trying to capture? What information do I want my colleagues to know about pre-approval and then post-launch of a particular project? All that information is typically captured in a custom form. Now the how is typically the process behind it, the approval process, the review process. So within Workfront, you can create reusable approval processes. So again, this controls the how information and projects ultimately are executed. An actual custom form is a series of fields that you can add that have labels, that have different field types. All of this information can be modeled within a form here via drag and drop. And this form can be reused anywhere within Workfront. Same is true of the approval process. Creating these approvals, these flows, they can ultimately be assigned to each project that you create within Workfront. However, it gets a little bit bothersome to manually attach these forms and processes to each project that you create. So we often create a series of templates. And templates within Workfront allow you to automatically assign approvals and custom forms to each project that's created based on this template. So here I've created a 3Share template. It automatically includes the custom form that I've created. It can automatically be associated with different programs or organizations or departments within your broader company. And it can help you facilitate conversation across all the different projects that you create based upon it. So if I were to come over to my implementation program and create a new project, I can see that there is a new project from template option. I select my template. And once I've entered some basic information, I now have a project that automatically has an approval assigned, automatically has the custom form fields that I've created. And it allows you to pre-populate really anything that you need. And so from there, you and your colleagues are well on your way to actually delivering the work without a tool or process getting in your way.